meeting. And that meeting is called to order at 7:43. And we do not need to do the pledge allegiance again, but we do need to take the roll call for members, please.
Angel Bebe?
Here.
Naomi Davidson?
Here.
Marius Tolmasen? Colin Hurd?
Here.
Maria Panzarella?
Here.
Patricia Smith?
Here.
Samantha Spalding?
Here.
Liz Rolo?
Here.
John Williams out. Seven present, two absent.
Right, moving along, we are going, I need to move approval for the minutes for February 22nd, 2012, and March 1st, 2012, special meeting.
November minutes, February, March, for March.
That's it, yep. Motion made by Colleen, seconded by Mrs. Rolo. Any questions? Roll call.
Angel Bebe? Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colin Hurd?
Hi.
Maria Panzarella?
Hi.
Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
I have to abstain for the February 22nd, I was not here, but yes for March 1st.
So you would say?
I'm okay for the 23rd, but I was not here for March 1st, so.
Okay, Liz Rolo?
Yes.
Motion carries.
At this time, we have a special presentation for an employee of ours that we are very fortunate to have in Runnymede, Mrs. Teresa Fortuna, regarding her heroic efforts during lunch on March 8, 2012, and helping one of our students, Dominic Freeman, at Bingham School. Dominic wanted to come on up and say real quick something.
All right.
what is revision for the main controversy gas line? And what are, what is that? On the panel?
We are actually going to table that this month. And we'll revisit it next month. Are you talking on the policies and public relations?
Yes.
The first reading is going to be tabled. Anyone else? Anything else, Mrs. Wilson? Anyone else? Okay, superintendent's report.
Okay, thank you. The enrollment as of February 29th was 858, which were together with students for special education, 844 in district, were remaining stable. Some of the activities in the district through the course of the last month have been, the three-year-old program has begun to fill up, the preschool program. There are a few remaining seats open. If anyone knows a child who is, there are no seats open at this point? Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. We did have, okay.
And she did not read the.
Okay. The budget adopt time is focused on refining the items and continuing to prioritize current future spending. Race to the top application was submitted. The final amount of funding was $12,729. And it was for all 4 years of the grant, so we have to spread out $12,729 for 4 years, as I have alluded to in the budget presentation. Spring activities are underway. The spring concert will be held April 5th up at Triton. Take a look at the district calendars on the web. They're full of all the things that are happening in the schools. I would like to publicly thank the Runyon PTA for supporting the trips, grades K to 2 and 4 to 7. Thank you very much. I think there's a wonderful collaboration between the PTA and the school district. For the board's information, I've completed my portion of the superintendent's evaluation, and hopefully you have received an email regarding that. HIV, there was one reported incident at Minden School, not found to be HIV. HIV in the report is attached. The legislature has approved funding for district HIV, but we don't know the amount yet. A couple of other things have come about since I've written to you last week. We have student artwork for students in grades 4 through 8 that will be displayed at the County Office of Education. So I commend our students at the Mary Gold School and Mrs. McFarland, their wonderful art teacher, who has framed very carefully a number of the pieces, and we're very happy to be honored at the County Office of Education. We would have gotten items from Bingham and Downey, but the art show is in April, and Mrs. Carpiaccoloy could not spare even one piece to be shown there. I also wanted to remind the board that we did confirm that we will be presenting the budget to Borough Council on April 3rd at 5:30. If you intend to go, then please let Joanne know. Joanne will have to fact check it at the public meeting, because if you have a forum of the board present. So 5:30, April 3rd, we will be doing this for Borough Council as well. Any questions for me?
Business administrator's report.
Thank you. During the last month, I obviously was working on the budget and reviewing that, updating. I also updated the EdJobs Fund cash management reports. I prepared submission paperwork for the submission to the county for the 12-13 budget. I also submitted the second part of the verification summary report for the Department of Agriculture. I resolved the discrepancy with the 2010-11 NPR completion report, which is a non-public report. Compiled and reviewed and finalized the extraordinary aid application. Submitted the ESERV report, certification of income tax compliance. Completed and submitted the 12-13 quarter 3 hour section 5-15-12 reporting. Completed and submitted the safety grant application with the New Jersey School Boards Association Insurance Group for $4,504. Actually, you have the approval of that submission. Complete and submit reimbursement request for the fiscal year 11-12 IDEA grant, as well as the NCLB grant, and attended various county meetings and workshops for the DOE fiscal issues, and my normal routine activities, which is the correspondence, monthly accounts,
sped by one bathroom on the third floor, so the teachers come back. At this time, it can't be used because we believe it's collapsed. We need to have a scope going in and verify that it is collapsed. And if so, then we have to find out what course of action we're going to take. We have some options at that time once we verify that that is the problem. At this point, that bathroom is shut down, can't be used because obviously it'll just back.
It doesn't affect the student bathrooms, it's just the faculty use bathroom?
Yeah, just the one bathroom.
Any other questions? PTA report, anything to report for PTA?
Yes, we had our bingo this week, approximately $900 bingo one night. Great success, but it's been a busy and full. They should invite, should be beyond five. And once again, we three top winners worked out perfectly, called out their number. And everybody left very happy with the prize we had, getting gearing up for our basket. Wonderful things are coming in, we're still looking for any donations. If any of you want to put something together as a board, or you want to send individuals, or more than one, we have them. Tickets will be on sale, $10 get in. It's a great night out, lots of good food. And we have our Las Vegas raffle, $5 each, $5.20. So I know y'all want to go to Las Vegas. Last year, we had this respect, our head made this one on our TV, so that was never, that was something wonderful. Wonderful response, a lot of people in town. A lot of different people sent us cash donations, which reduced the purchase, and like we told them, they will recognize, and so it's really working out well. The students are excited, the little ones are definitely their dad, because they just, a couple were just asking if I can take them, they wanted to make a basket. But hopefully their mom will come with a basket too. But it's going very, very well.
Thank you, and thank you again for your support with field trips, we greatly appreciate it.
And we actually really have talked about this before, when we had the Educational Foundation meeting, the teachers were there, they talked about it. That was the goal that they had, and just feel that if we can move forward with this, and it's something that hopefully will work out well, and we'll just get it.
Pat, do you have any idea of how much it costs PTA to fund all this?
We're waiting for the transportation report. Now, I have to check with our girls, because we found that after the fact, I found out that the students always paid if they had a down for their trip, $10, $12. We're looking into the one trip is $12.95, I believe, the other one is $8.50. The zoo is free, it's one something for the buses, so we're going to pay that. So it's not going to cost them anything. Middle school trips are $10 a piece, I think both trips. So that's what we're looking at is where we are now. They're $10 for each trip, and I think that the movies or the show is $8.50. So we didn't get the opportunity to sit down with Ms. Galloway ahead of time, because this was all kind of up in the air. We may fund every piece of everything, but we didn't know where they were going and what was happening. So that, right now, I'm waiting to have my meeting next month to say, this is where we are. We believe that we will be fine with that. And you're talking $850 for the second grade trip, basically, $850. And if you go with $900 for fourth grade, $800, it's not that much money. It's not that. To us, if we can continue to have a bingo that we make $1,000, and we can have the basket option, which we made $7,000 last year, our goal is $10,000 this year. Right. If we can do that and move forward that way without training our families, then that's what our main goal is, to fund them and get them going to places, the museums and the things, or the different things that they don't get to do with their families. That's our goal, is to go to educational places and they don't have to go with their families. Because, there's a lot of children. I know my grandchildren get all of them. But there's a lot of people that are both working families. They don't have grandparents. I know when I grew up, I got nowhere except for my one aunt who took it. And we still have a lot of families like that. And these trips, I think, are very important. And they get to see the things that they want to see. So that's our goal.
It's all about the kids, right, Mrs. Wilson?
It is. And we're still, we just got our totals from our book fair. We're ready to give the teachers the books, so that we start buying books. young mothers, because some of us old ones have been around a long time. And, you know, you kind of got to where people are, you know, what we're getting there, they're getting, that you have to get them on that, you know, the kids come first, the government. You know, it's not about just selling and just having something, you know, but we're moving in the right direction. With your support, so we could do without your support even, so.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Wilson. Camden County Ed Services, Press, Jersey School Board.
I went to a seminar on this weekend, and I will, just hand in my report, it's very lengthy, and I don't want to take up a lot of time, but, it was very interesting seminar about how boards of education are very responsible in setting the goals for student achievement, and how, we as a board, you know, how we evaluate year to year, and just off the end of our budget, we need, communication, our assessments for our children, we need to always have that in the forefront of what we do, and that's student achievement. So it was a very good seminar, and I would recommend it for anybody that, if they want to try to take it to one of the institutions that they're going to have on October 12th, or try to get the same people to come in and talk to them.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Black Horse Pike. Curriculum progress, policy, public relations.
I've been attending, the planning and zoning board meetings. I was there to, the school board to attend the meetings, because they're supposed to be putting up a new housing unit, and the builders were there. No votes took place, seems like this is going to go on for another couple months. There's an issue with the borough ordinance, that the, borough council passed an ordinance saying you can have townhouses, but they didn't set no specifications to the planning board, you know, just going back and forth. But the people there were able to ask the builders, their attorneys were there, their engineers, all that were all there. And one gentleman got up and he asked a question, because the rumor going around is it's supposed to be low income housing, and they're looking at anywhere from 55 to 59 units back there, depending on the specifications, depending on whether there's wetlands back there, whether they can build in certain areas, or whether they can't build. And the one question from a homeowner that backed to that area was, you know, because they were talking about it being low income, was, you know, the values of our home have gone down so much. When I bought my house, he can't refinance because he owes too much on the house, and the value of the home is so low now. So he had asked them, you know, if you're building these low-income houses, you know, how is this going to affect me now? Well, the builder said, he never said they were building low-income housing. He said that the homes that they plan on building, they will be charging anywhere from $190,000 to $200,000 per home. That's what he said at the meeting. So nothing has been done. This is going to be a process, because council and planning and zoning have to come up with specifications, come up with the correct ordinance before that they will even present a plan or an application with the specifications of exactly what they plan on doing. So basically, I think there's a lot of talk going around, but until, you know, we get an actual formal application from them stating exactly what they plan on doing,
thank you. Nothing on policy, Mr. Chairman.
No, just that, sorry, I've been reiterating again, we are opening the table, this facility of 7510, and the others are for second reading, we're mandating not to do that, so.
Negotiations. Progress. Finance. Personnel and property, I believe, are the ones that are signed. Property, sorry.
We just went over some things that we had discussed previously about upgrading different areas of our school that need to be upgraded. So nothing came out of it. We just discussed different situations and what needs to be done, what can wait, what will have to be planned into the budget prior to the prior year.
Future.
Future.
Thank you. All right. Property and transportation, use of facilities, field trips, and items 3, 4, and 5. Motion made by Patty, seconded by Maria. Are there any questions? No? Roll call.
Angel Beebe? Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colleen Hurd?
Yes.
Maria Panzarella?
Yes.
Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
Yes.
Lynn Terrell?
Yes.
Motion carries seven to zero.
Under personnel, I need a motion to approve items number 1 through 7.
I'd like to make a motion to approve under numbers 1 through 7 under personnel.
Second.
Motion made by Naomi, seconded by Colleen. Are there any questions?
Question number 6, is stipend, is that appropriate for the program?
Any other questions? Roll call.
Angel Beebe? Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colleen Hurd?
Yes.
Maria Panzarella?
Yes.
Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
Yes.
Lynn Terrell?
Yes.
Motion carries seven to zero.
Mr. DiGiorgio, Mr. Evangelist, your use of facilities was approved. Maria wants to be in charge.
I said I called it out, like, they even know that.
Under finance, I need a motion to approve items number 1, number 2, the professional development workshops, 3 through 7. So 1 to 7, too. Motion made by Patty, seconded by Colleen. Are there any questions?
Yes, number 6. The maintenance agreement, is that an ongoing fee paid by the year? That's an actual, that's just a number.
This will be the first year that we're doing it because currently they are still under just physical warranty.
Any other questions? Roll call.
Angel Beebe?
Yes.
Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colleen Hurd?
Yes.
Maria Panzarella?
Yes.
Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
Yes.
Lynn Terrell?
Yes.
Motion carries seven to zero.
Under curriculum, I need a motion to approve items number 1 through 4. Motion made by Colleen, seconded by Naomi. Are there any questions? Roll call.
Angel Beebe?
Yes.
Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colleen Hurd?
Yes.
Maria Panzarella?
Yes.
Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
Yes.
Lynn Terrell?
Yes.
Motion carries seven to zero.
Policies and public relations. I need a motion for items number 1 and 2.
There's some new information that the policy committee would probably want to consider before putting the first reading on, and after doing a little bit of research. So,
so Liv made a motion. Can I get a second?
For the table.
For the table.
For the table.
Right, number 1, seconded by Colleen. Mr. Stern, do I need a roll call on that?
Yes.
Roll call.
Angel Beebe?
Yes.
Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colleen Hurd?
Yes.
Maria Panzarella? Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
Yes.
Lynn Terrell?
Yes.
I need to, a motion to approve items number two and number three. Hold on, let's get the motion first. Motion?
I make a motion to approve items two and three.
Second.
Motion made by Colleen, seconded by Naomi. Colleen has a question.
Is it like this year we changed, we have to give a day or something? The kids came back and it was a holiday guy, reverse the holiday.
So we're off January 1st.
Right, so do we need you off January 2nd?
Yeah. Because we're off January 1st, it was on Tuesday. It was on the weekend before. That was a Sunday. I do want to let you know that this is the calendar that the REA also reviewed, so everyone has had input into this and it was voted on.
And was there a difference between the initial one we received and the revised?
What revised is, yes, the revised calendar is, looks like this, the March date. We met yesterday as an administrative team and they asked if we could take our March date to the back.
I would attach mine.
Or it should be a white sheet in back after all of the green sheets.
Under the green sheets.
The revision is that the March date. The March date had previously been for the conference days on the 11th and 12th and the professional development day being the 13th. Instead of the beginning of the week being one session days, it's the end of the week. So it's the 13th is the professional development day and then the conference days are 14th.
Any other questions? Roll call.
Amy Reedy? Naomi Davidson?
Yes.
Colleen Hurd?
Yes.
Maria Panzarella?
Yes.
Patricia Smith?
Yes.
Samantha Spalding?
Yes.
Patricia Perla?
Yes.
Richard Perry, seven.
It is now time for public comments on any items. The public is reminded that all public complaints against a district employee must be made through a specific grievance process. A description of this process may be found in Board of Ed Policy File Code 0167. This policy is available upon request from the Office of the Board Secretary. Any individual named an employee in a complaint before the Board of Education without the employee's permission could be cited for violating that employee's civil and contractual rights. Any public comments? No? All right, at this time, I need a motion to go into executive session.
Make a motion to begin for executive session.
Motion made by Colleen, seconded by Maria. Resolved that pursuant to Section 8 of the Public Meetings Act, the public shall be excluded from that portion of the meeting involving the discussion of legal and personnel matters. Further resolved, the discussion of such subject matters discussed in executive session can be disclosed to public upon official action, if any, at the conclusion of the executive session or a public session at some later date. All in favor?
Aye.
You guys are, can everyone please stay here because since... It probably should be noted that we will possibly be out for up to an hour.